Friday against the Cubs. Good afternoon inside a broadcast booth at Miller Park. Alongside Bill Schroeder, I'm Matt LePay. We'll check in with Sophia Minert in just a couple of minutes. Well, blowout win last night, 18 runs, most ever this franchise has put up against the Cardinals. In a nutshell, they had everything going, beginning with the numbers, runners, and scoring position. That was huge.
Yeah, it's been a problem just about the entire season, but last night the Brewers really were able to get the job done. Runners in scoring position, numbers outstanding, 8 for 12. The Brewers actually in the fourth inning were 5 for 6 with runners in scoring position. Now look, you'd like to be able to see these big numbers. 44 runs last week, 37 of them coming in two games. I think the Brewers would prefer to see 6 a night as opposed to, you know, the big numbers. But 8 players in the original lineup able to score a run and drive in a run, 9 total. And it all comes up to, you know, the big boys in the lineup. They got it going early and giving the Brewers something to build on early in the game. The two home runs, one by Yelich, one by Braun, gave the Brewers a lead. It was actually a come-from-behind victory last night. They were actually behind 1-0 in the first inning. Kind of a crazy stat.
14 of them now, if you're keeping track. 14 comeback wins this season. That's your T-Mobile ticket to the game. Well, as Rock said, the big boys really got things started, and that certainly includes Christian Yelich with a big night. He's been asked about it all season long, trying to get through these season-long struggles. Big step in the right direction last night. For more on Yelly, we check in with Sophia Minert.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, and Rock said it, the come-from-behind win. Not often that you score 18 runs, and you can say that, but they were able to come from behind because of what Christian Yelich and Ryan Braun did in that first inning, going back-to-back homers off of Jack Flaherty. They were able to get to him for 9 runs, a career high for Flaherty. And Christian Yelich knows that if this team is going to get into...
giving him a bit of a problem as of late, so going to be important for Woodruff to keep the Cardinals off the board early. And Wainwright not giving up a whole lot so far this year.
All right, there you see the numbers for Brandon Woodruff this season. He's opposing his mound opponent on Friday. John Lester after the game said, hey, with Woodruff and Corbin Burns, that's a heck of a top of your rotation. And he's not kidding, as he will look to get the Brewers a win here in the opener of this doubleheader is Mike Schilt. You'll see him in game one. You will not see him in game two. He is serving a one-game suspension for the events of last night, which cooler heads did ultimately prevail. We should tell you that. Let's check out the Cardinals batting order presented by Hyundai. Tommy Edman will be in the leadoff spot, followed by Paul DeJong and Paul Goldschmidt. Brad Miller, again, DHing and hitting cleanup. Matt Carpenter moving up a couple of spots in the order, followed by Tyler O'Neill. Justin Williams just called up. Harrison Bader and Yadier Molina got banged up last night, but right back behind the plate for this opener of the Twin Bill.
Now let's check out the Brewers defensively behind Woody here in game one. Yelich, Garcia, Gamble in the outfield. Yeah, Peterson, Arcia on the left side, Keston here, Jed Jerko on the right side, and Omar Narvaez behind home plate.
Let's check out the umpire crew here for this doubleheader. Chris Siegel in game four, a playoff spot. Let's check out the batting order for the Brew crew presented by Hyundai. Avi Garcia will be at the top, followed by Yelich and Hira. Daniel Vogelback swinging a very good bat as a Brewer. He hits cleanup. Jerko, Gamble, Peterson, Arcia, and Narvaez. Rounding out the starting nine against the veteran 39-year-old Adam Wainwright.
Yeah, Wainwright in his major league career, 166 wins, 96 losses. Outstanding numbers for Wainwright. Took his only loss of the year his last time out against Cincinnati. 3 runs and 6.